That's why a man came to Imam al-Hasan al-Basri, رحمه الله تعالى, the Imam of al-Basra, probably the Imam of al-Tabi'een. He said, يا أبا سعيد أمؤمن أنت؟ He said, oh Abu Sa'id, that was Hasan al-Basri's kunya. Are you a believer? Hasan al-Basri being a scholar of Islam, a faqih, a person who understood the Quran, he says, الإيمان إيمانان. Iman is two levels. أما الإيمان بالله ورسوله وملائكته وكتبه واليوم الآخر والقضاء والقدر فأنا مؤمن بكل ذلك. Conviction that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped, that Muhammad is His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, that there is the last day, there is angels, there has been messages sent down, revelations and messengers, and that the pre-decree of Allah, Al-Qadr, I believe in all of this. I have a conviction about all of this. And he says, there is the Iman where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِيمَانٌ إِمَانُ الَّذِينَ قَالَ اللَّهُ فِيهِمْ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا. Refers to the verse, he says, there's another level of Iman where Allah says, indeed, the believers are only the ones that when the name of Allah is mentioned, their hearts tremble. The hearts shake. Something resonates with them at a deep level. Is the faith responds to the words of Allah. وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلِيهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When His words are recited to them, they increase in Iman. They evolve in Iman. They accept them favorably. They look forward to them. They embrace them. They embody them. They absorb them. They submit themselves to them. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And they put their trust in Allah. These are inner things. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Those who establish the prayer. Read through the Quran, the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah mentions about the Quran being guidance for the muttaqeen, hudan lil-muttaqeen. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Those who believe in the unseen, those who establish the prayer, those who spend from what we have given them. So Al-Hasan al-Basri says, أَمَّا هَذَا الْإِيمَانِ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ فَلَا أَدْرِي أَمُؤْمِنٌ أَنَا أَمْ لَا. He says, as to the higher level of Iman, which is when I hear the name of Allah, my heart shakes and my whole inner dimension is caught by the beauty of the words of Allah or by the name of Allah, I don't know if I am that level of Iman. I don't know. And thus we have to have this humility and not take the name Islam for granted that I'm a Muslim. We don't know. We don't know how much faith have. Do we have enough faith inside that would save us from the hellfire? That would make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins on the day of judgment? Allow us into paradise? Because none of our deeds is going to get us into paradise. The Messenger says, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدٌ مِّنْكُمُ الْجَنَّةَ بِعَمَلِهِ. None of you will enter paradise because of their deeds. Your deeds won't be enough to make you enter paradise. فَقَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ وَلَا أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. The companion said, O Messenger of Allah, what about you? Your deeds won't get you into paradise. He says, وَلَا أَنَا. وَلَا أَنَا إِلَّا أَنْ يَتَغَمَّدَنِي اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَةٍ مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلٍ. Even my deeds won't get me into paradise unless Allah showers me with His forgiveness and mercy. His bounty. So as a Muslim, there is no sort of ceiling that I'm a Muslim, I take that for granted. Every day, you have to grow in faith. At least you have to strive to grow. Every day you wake up, you open your eyes, you realize this is a day that was given to you to increase your level of Iman, to become a better believer, a better Muslim. Every day is a challenge for you. It's a constant struggle. Every day you rise the bar higher for yourself. And you focus on the things that Allah loves the most. And what are these things? As Allah says in the divine hadith, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّ افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ. My servant does not seek nearness to me by anything that I love more than the things I made an obligation. Allah made them obligation because Allah loves them the most. And the hallmark of Tawheed, the hallmark of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to make your will, your desire, follow the will of Allah. So you try to align your will with the will of Allah. So what Allah loves the most is the obligations. So you do the obligations. Before you go about refining your worship and fine-tuning it, you get the foundations right. You get what Allah loves right. And then after that, you go into the details. You start fixing and refining and improving the quality. But you have to get the foundation right, because that's what Allah loves the most. That shows sound heart and a reasonable mind. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who